Welcome back guys to the third video of this series, and in this video we will finally cover the animation effect. So we want to animate these links also, and the images and the text. So for this animation I'll be using a library called Anime.js. You can head on to Anime.js.com and check out. This is a fun library where you can easily animate, and it's super easy to understand. As you can read the documentation, if you are familiar with CSS properties, then you can start with anime.js in no time. So for getting started with anime.js, head on to their GitHub page, and there you can find how to install. If you are using npm, then you can simply run npm install anime.js and then import it, or you can manually download the anime.min.js file and link it in your HTML file, as I have done. Here you can see anime.min.js file in my JS folder, and in index.html I have linked that file, and that's it. That's enough to start using anime.js. And this is my file animation.js, which is currently empty. Another change that I have made is that I have divided each link into individual letters. As you can see here, for art I have divided this into three divs with A, R, T, and given each one of them a class of letter. I've done this because I want the animation to flow through each letter, and that's why I have divided each into individual letters. If you haven't used anime.js before, then don't worry, you will still be able to understand every single thing. So let's start writing some code. So first of all, let's add some simple animation when the page loads in. We want this MyNav to come from different sides, and the images and the text coming from different sides. So let's start with that. So first of all, I'll add an event listener to our document, and that event is DOM content loaded. So when all the contents are loaded, we will start animating things. So I'm creating here anime.timeline. Now by timeline, I mean every other animation that I will add here using dot add, they will run in a sequence. So by timeline, and I'm defining a sequence. So first of all, let's target our nav and give this a property. From left, we want the transition come from 5% to 16%, and the easing that I'm using is ease out expo, and I want this animation to take a duration of 1500 milliseconds, and the opacity I want it from 0 to 1. Now let's see how this looks. As you can see, this is coming from left to its correct position. Now let's animate the image. So for that image, I'm gonna add, and target this time will be e.image at the back, and we want its top property from 40%, from 46% to 56%, and for easing I'm using ease out expo, and then again I am using a duration of 1500 and opacity from 0 to 1. Let's have a look. Now as you can see, when the first animation completes, then the second one starts. So in order to we can use offset property. By offset we mean start this animation 100 milliseconds before the first one. As you can see, the first animation is not yet complete, but the second still starts. Now let's change it to something like 1300. Now you can see the second animation starts 1300 milliseconds before the first one. Now let's target the text. So for text, I'm targeting them dot text and setting its left property from 80%. Let me check what property I'm using for the text. So text, I'm using right 10%. So I want it from right 8% to 10%, and easing again, ease out expo. A duration of 1500 milliseconds and opacity from 0 to 1. And then again I am using an offset of minus 1200. So this will start 1200 milliseconds before the second one finishes. That looks good. Now let's create the main animation for the images and the text. So first of all, I will target all the links that we have, as we have given them each one of them a different ID. So for art link, I am using document.query selector, or maybe you can use document.getElementById, and the ID is art link. Similarly, three more links for work link. Then online link, and then finally the collection link. Now I'm creating a new array of link array, and I'm adding all these links into that array so that we are able to loop through this array and give each one of them an event listener. So I'm gonna loop through the array using first of all, I'm creating an image object where I will copy and paste the links for each image that I'll be using. So for art, I'm using an image, and all of these images are basically I've copy pasted from Unsplash. You can use any other image source or you can use your own images. So let me copy it. So for art, I'm using this link, and then for work image, a different link. For online image, and finally for collection image. Let me create some more room. Now I'm creating another object named people. Inside this we will have our name and designation for each category. So for art, I'm defining name Anders Kalberg. You can use any other name and designation. Similarly for work, then for online, so that's it for the people object. Now let's loop through our array. So I'm using for each and link array. For each link, I want to add an event listener, that is click, and on this click we will start animating things. So I'm passing event in our callback function, and then I'm switching link. So first of all, case, this is art link, and for art link I'm calling a function that will define letter, that is change content, and I'm passing the link along with the images.artimage and people.art. Let's add the break statement. Similarly, three more cases. So art link, then we have work link, and for work link I will pass image.workimage and people.work. And for online image, again same function with different attribute. and finally the collection link. Now let's define the function changeContent. We have the link, the image and the person object, where we have the name and the designation. So again I am creating a timeline, and then we will target first of all the image. So let me show you what we are doing. We want this image to go up, and while it is up we will change the image source and then bring it back from bottom to its correct position. So in this way we can create a slide animation effect. So first of all, let's target the image and then translate it from its translate y to -700. This will make this image go up and set its opacity to 0. And this time I'm using ease in expo, and the duration it will be 700 millisecond. Now let's have a look. As you can see, whenever you click on it, the image goes up. Now let's add the code to bring it back. So let's define a property complete. So this tells us when the animation complete, what we can do. So in this we can write document dot query selector dot image back image. And when this animation complete, we will simply change its source to the image that we received in this function. This is the image. So for art link, we will get the art image, and we will change this dot image back image source to the art image. Now let's add the animation to bring it back. So for bringing it back, I am using 700 to 0, so it will come from bottom to its correct position. And its opacity will change from 0 to 1, and this time using which will be ease out expo, and duration let's keep this to 900 millisecond. Now let's have a look. As you can see, it looks perfect. Now let's do the same thing for our images, for our text. So for text, first of all let's add the animation to make them go up. So target will be name and the designation. In order to target multiple tags in anime.js, you can simply separate them by a comma. So let's translate them by -200 pixels and set its opacity to 0, and easing will be again ease in expo, and the duration will be 800 millisecond. And again I'm setting an offset property to -= 700, and when this one completes we will simply change the text. So for that I will first select the name tag query selector dot name and change it text content to the person dot name that we received as an attribute. Now the same thing for the designation. So for art we will receive the person object, and we can write person dot name and person dot designation. Now let's have a look. Now add the animation to bring it back. So let's change the translate property from 200 to 0 and opacity from 0 to 1, and the easing will become ease out expo, and let's remove the complete, we don't want it here. Now let's have a look. It seems not working, maybe I have made some error. Let me check it. Yes, I forgot to add the ending brackets. That should work now. Yes, it is working. But now you can see the name and the designation are going at the same time. But we want a slight delay. So for that, I can use a delay property which takes a parameter as element and an I which is the index. Since in target we have the name and the designation, so for each element it will add a delay of I into 100. So for the first the delay will be 0 and for the second it will be 100 millisecond. Let's have a look. Now that looks perfectly fine. So that's why we use delay. It added a slight delay to the designation property. Now let me add a little hover on the list element. So for that I have already added a transition property of all, and on hover we will change its color to orange. Let's have a look. Now it's changing to orange. Now we will finally add the hover animation. So for that I am creating a new file named hover.js, and also link it in your index.html file. And in this we will write the code for our hover that will flow through each letter and give this a zigzag effect. So for that I am again calling the event is listener DOM content loaded, and let's target our links. So for that I am using document.query selector all dot list and a. So we have a reference to all the links and that will be stored in the links array. And now we will loop through it, and for each link I will add an event listener, and the event listener will be mouse enter. So whenever the mouse enters on any of this link, the link will get animated. Now let's target the letter in this link. So for that link dot query selector all dot letter. So all the letters will be stored in the letter array. Now we can write targets our letter without the semicolon. So now we have that in targets we have the array of letter, and we will translate it. And for that I'm again passing the function element and I, and for each element I the translate y will be I percentage 3 minus. I will explain you what is happening here, and the duration will be 300. And for delay again I am running the loop for each element, and slight delay that is 30 milliseconds. So now when we hover on any of these links, you can see, let me zoom in. So I percentage 3 means for the first element it does not translate at all, and for every third element it does not translate because 3 percentage 3 is 0, that is the mod function. And for 1% 3 translate by 1 pixels, and for the second it translates by 2 pixels. Now you can even increase by how much it translate, but first of all let's add another event listener for mouse leave as the animation that we are adding. We have to remove it once the mouse leaves, so I'm copy pasting it again. We don't need the duration and the delay. And for translate y I'm simply using 0. So now when the mouse will leave, it will come back to its original position. So you can increase by multiplying it by 2. Now for the first element it will translate by 2 pixel, the second will translate by 4 pixel, but each third will remain at the same position, as you can see now. So with that we have completed the slide animation effect. As you can see, everything is working perfectly fine. So I hope you like this video, you have learned something from it, and If you really like this video, then please hit the like button and don't forget to subscribe. I will keep making more similar videos. So that's it for today, and I will see you in the next one.